Booze, Bullets, and Broads by Bruce Sively. Guilty pleasure. That's what the Matt Helm movies are for me. I was introduced to Matt Helm the same way I was introduced to James Bond, through television in the early 1970s. And even then, barely a teenager, I could sense that despite their similarities, there were fundamental differences that went beyond one being the British spy and the other being the American spy. Bond was always cooler than Helm. Even when the 007 movies of the 70s took on Helm's overt self-mockery. The Bond films had better production values, better scripts, and better dialogue. The early Bond films had the feel of something fresh. Helm had the musk of an old 40s programmer, an old fogey's view of 60s spoofery. Yet the films still entertained me, perhaps because they had the ambiance of a high school play. We know it's awful, but hey, we're having a good time doing it. And most importantly of all, they had Dean. Dean Martin was one of the most popular American stars of the 1960s. He was the establishment personification of cool. A hard liquor drinking, chain smoking, womanizing crooner with an insouciant devil may care persona. Casting him as America's answer to James Bond seemed to make a statement. And the statement was that all that 007 machismo and sex appeal was a joke. Sean Connery with his Scots accent and toupees was as much a phony as Martin's Matt Helm. Get over it. Enjoy it. And for heaven's sake, don't take it seriously.